Welcome to our RBT study guide series. In this multi-part chapter, we're diving deep into chaining. Chaining refers to the various methods used when linking specific sequences of stimuli and response in order to form new performances. In other words, chaining breaks the path down into smaller steps. Then each step is taught within a clear sequence. There are three types of chaining: forward chaining, backward chaining, and total task. In forward chaining, we teach a learner how to complete the first step of the task independently. For example, when teaching a learner how to brush their teeth, we will teach the first step, which is to pick up brush and toothpaste, and the rest of the steps will be prompted. Once the learner can complete the first step without prompt, then they can work on completing the next steps. A real-life example for forward training would be learning choreography for a dance performance. The performance is broken down into smaller steps. You have to learn the first step of the sequence in order to move on to the next one, or simply, making a cup of coffee. You have to follow a list of steps in order to make the perfect cup. In this example, the instructor teaches the first step, to lift the handle, and then proceeds to do the rest of the steps, such as inserting a coffee pod, closing the lid, placing a cup at the base, pressing the on button, wait for the coffee to finish dispensing, and last but not least, take the cup. We hope this video has been a good introduction to chaining. Make sure to watch the second part where we go over backwards chaining. If you would like to learn more about ABA terms and techniques, stay tuned for more educational videos. Leave a comment below to share your ideas and feedback with us, and don't forget to like and subscribe. See you next time!